Hi, welcome to ProgeCAD Malaysia. Today I would like to share something with you, every one of you. Under normal circumstances, when we want to insert a sitemap, what do we normally do? We will actually go to Google Maps, copy the map, and then insert into the drawing and trace accordingly, and then remove the image file. I have one other method that may be useful to you. So, but then we go on to the first method, how we normally does it. First, go to Google Maps. I found the location that I wanted. I will print screen. Next, we'll go to Windows Paint, which is freely available in any Windows operating system. Then we paste the print screen or the image onto this application. Then we select the area that we wanted to crop it. Say we wanted somewhere around here. Then we crop it. And then we save the file as JPEG. So I'm going to name this as map. So once we save this map JPEG, we'll go back to ProgeCAD. Then we'll go into insert image. We'll look for the map, open. Then we will just insert the map into the DWG. So from here, what we normally does, we will just draw lines accordingly. So let's give an example. Let's create a layer manager first. Add new. We put it as road. And then the color would be yellow. But depends on your plot style. We close this. So we'll activate road as the current active layer. Then we start drawing lines. Something like this. We'll trace all the lines accordingly. I think this will be a good example. So we zoom out. And now we will go under the insert again and then go image manager and then unload. Click OK. You should see some of the lines already been traced, and then you do whatever necessary onto your sitemap. Now comes a different method that I would like to share with you in this video. First, you go under the add-on and then raster to vector icon here. Click on it. Now we open up the same map. Before you do anything, go under image, convert this to grayscale, and then again under image, gamma, go down as low as possible to 0.1, so we can get a negative image, just like in photograph. Once you get this negative image, you just have to click on this call one touch vectorization. Once you have done this, you go under file, save the vectors as, again we'll save as map DFX. Remember, it has to be DXF because only then you can actually import into your DWG file as a vector. So we'll save this. Now you go back to ProgeCAD. Open the DXF drawing. So you get that map there. So what you need to do is we go back to the same location here. We will erase all the unnecessary information. Go back to layer, manager, create a new layer called road, and then the color. Earlier we put yellow, I'm going to use the yellow color again. And I, as I said, it depends on your plot style, what color for which pen width and size is up to your requirement. So for this demo purpose, it will be yellow. We'll move this to road yellow. We'll highlight this, and then we'll put it by layer. So this layer, we'll change it to road yellow. So once we have done that, we can erase some of the minor information that may not be correct. And then we will add lines into it. And there you go. Basically, you get the same effect of when you trace this portion, and this actually is the tracing for you, and you just need to fix up the ends where this is, those are not correctly captured. So you just fix it up with some adjustment here and there. I would think this will speed up the whole process, and it will be a useful tool if you have some kind of production that you need to do some kind of drawings similar to this. Basically, I seen a lot of architects are using site maps and location maps for their drawings, especially for their submission to authority purposes and so forth. So this is the tips that I would like to share with you, and hope that it will help you in your 2D production and in your DWG drawings. Thank you for watching. Bye.